everyone. I'm Monsignor Jim Flaunt. Welcome to Good News. Here's Karen Danker-Smith, my co-host.
Everyone.
How are you?
I'm good, Monsignor.
Doing
how are you
well?
Doing?
Doing very, very well.
Glad to hear
You know, I was asked to help out at a fundraiser recently.
Okay.
So they wanted, like, an autographed cookbook from me, you know? Uh-huh. And they wanted one from Lydia. So I got one from Lydia. I got mine. And then they said, could you come and cook?
Oh.
But, like, it was for a good cause. You know, like, it was for one of our schools, you know? So, like, I wound up getting involved, and I was cooking for dinner for 100 people.
Wait, you course. Had to feed everybody?
Yes, I had to cook the dinner. They canceled the catering. It was...
Oh, my goodness.
It was a lot. But it was fun. I love doing that kind of stuff, like reaching out, helping, you know, because every little bit you do makes a difference. In the Catholic school where you are, I mean, you're probably not stopping that, right?
Yeah, we fundraise all the time. And you know what's so great about doing that in a Catholic school with children? The excitement and enthusiasm that well, no matter what we do, no matter what organization we fundraise for, they just had a fundraiser for St. Jude Hospital, and the children get so excited, especially when they know they're helping other children.
Oh,
and
yeah,
just
sure,
that enthusiasm right? and joy, and it's contagious. And then
do they
get
still
excited.
Do the traditional stuff like the candy drive and the magazine?
Oh, of course.
That's all still around too.
Yes, and that's exciting too because there's always prizes and
you
everything.
Get the Bippo. Yeah, I remember that stuff.
Yeah, that's
when I was,
right.
Yeah, back in the day.
But it's exciting for us because they're excited. So
well, you know, it's funny. It's ironic because our show today talks a little bit about these people who are making a difference, who are reaching out and really making a difference in the community. You know,
we
have some religious women with us today too, who are really making a difference in the community.
Yes,
and have changed lives of people. You know, it reminds me. Well, this show really would be best viewed. Thinking about that starfish story, you know that thing?
Yes,
two walking along the seashore and he's throwing starfish back in. And his friend says to him, you're never going to be able to throw all these starfish back in. What are you doing? He goes, no, but I could save this one.
This
and he throws
one.
It back in.
I know.
And I think, like, if the world, if we live like that, things would begin to change,
I
right?
I agree 100%.
So that's what we're kind of looking at today, like how we can make a difference in the world, right?
Everybody can do something.
All right, I'm going to take out my dollars. I'll buy a candy bar from her while we get going. Let's get going. St. Angela Merici, foundress of the Ursuline Sisters, once said, give good example, teaching more by what you do than what you say. Well, led by that call, the Ursuline Sisters of Tildank strive to make God known and loved by standing with the oppressed and economically poor. And in 1991, Sister Myrid Barrett founded New Ground, an organization providing services to help families and veterans break the cycle of poverty and homelessness. For over 20 years now, they recognize that the key to solving these issues is not only to help those who are homeless now, but also to prevent it in the future. So please welcome Sister Myrid Barrett and Shannon Boyle, Executive Director of New Ground, to our show. Thanks for being
here.
Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
I think, you know, I feel very close to the Ursuline Sisters because of all of the retreats that I made at what is your mother house right here on Long Island. I did the 30-day retreat there, lots of 10-day retreats there, and then once I became a priest, lots of retreats we did there. So you've provided like a tremendous resource, your community, to Long Island for, I don't know, how many years? I mean, it's a long time, right?
We've been on Long Island since 1935. We've been in Blue Point.
Wow.
Yes.
And I remember there was a building that burned down and then a new building was built, right?
That's right. That's right. When we came in 35, it was mainly the place for the novitiate and where we were all trained and some of us began our college courses there and then would go into St. John's. In the meantime, we had a retreat house up in Oyster Bay Cove, also called St. Ursula's Center. And then when the house in Blue Point was burned, we sold the house in Oyster Bay to rebuild.
And now it's no longer used for retreat as much, right? The
Ursuline
Center, but for your sisters who are retired, is that what it is?
That's right. The sisters who are retired and living independently live on that retreat side of the house.
Okay.
The big living room and the big dining room and the kitchen are still there. And the sisters who live independently, actually two of them are still working. They're not all retired, but those living units became available. And then the other side of the house has a small unlicensed infirmary and then assisted living.
Wow, it's incredible. Now, how did New Ground come about with all of this? Yeah, I'm interested.
Well, New Ground came about because I was teaching for about 18 years doing formal teaching. And as I did my graduate studies at Mary Knoll School of Theology, I was very impacted by the intensification of the work I did with social analysis and an internship in Bogota, Colombia. I felt that as an educator, I could make a difference by working with the large undocumented population that was on the island at a while. And one of our sisters was looking to open a shelter, and we did. And five of us lived in that shelter, the Angela Merici Inn in Bayshore.
Wow.
We lived there for 5 years and took care of homeless families. Some were financed by DSS. They were on welfare. And others, we raised the money to keep because we all worked and paid our rent. And then after 5 years there, and during those 5 years, I saw that that was what we call a Band-Aid approach, mm-hmm. that giving housing is great, giving food and shelter is great, helping people, teaching people take care of their babies is great, but it became a revolving door.
Yeah.
People would leave and they'd be back in 3 months or 4 months through a myriad of reasons, no money, domestic violence, fleeing the police, whatever it was.
Yeah.
So I wrote the program for Newground. We provide intensive educational services and social work services. Okay. And Shannon will talk more about the actuality of the services and the details, but the goal of getting people for more than 3 to 5 years to really buy in to change their life, mm-hmm. that was what we needed.
Mm-hmm.
That the schooling is too disruptive for the children to be successful at school.
It's the old, like, teach a man to fish mm-hmm. versus give.
Exactly.
Right, that kind of mentality.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And Shannon, how did you get involved in New
Something
Brown?
Tells me in 1991 you were not involved in that. Something tells me that.
That's a good guess. I started with Newground in 2002, and I was lucky enough to apply for a job as a social worker. That's my background. I have a master's in social work. I started at Newground doing direct service work with our families and some work with the veterans, and over a period of years ended up getting promoted and became director of clinical services. And in 2006, when Maraid was moving to her order leadership, I became the executive director.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Now talk about the veteran component of this, because I think that might be a question mark on some people's foreheads. Say, well, what do veterans need? I don't understand what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a tremendous need among our veterans, right?
Correct. The Nassau and Suffolk County have a tremendous number of veterans. It's one of the largest populations of veterans in the country. Mm-hmm. And there are quite a few veterans that are homeless, unfortunately. So our program, we have two components. We have the family component, where the families reside in separate apartments that are tend to primarily be in two-family homes in various areas of Nassau County and a couple in Suffolk. And then the veteran component is for single male veterans. They all reside in one home. They each have their own bedrooms. They share the common spaces. And they're doing the same work as the families. They're really trying to put their lives back together. Many go back to school. We help them go back to school. Increase their education and their earning potential so that when they graduate out of Newground, they're able to afford market rent. They have a career. They have a steady income. We also do a tremendous amount of financial literacy work. Many of the veterans and families, when they come to us, are in extreme debt. Their credit scores mm-hmm. are terrible. And I think one thing that has really changed since I've come to Newground is that credit reports really matter. Over mm-hmm. the last 10 years, employers look at that. Car insurance rates mm-hmm. are based on that, a whole slew of things. And so to be able to help our families and veterans pay off their debt, improve their credit scores, that's going to allow them to be independent, self-sufficient members of society when they leave us, which is our goal.
Now, how does the community at large help you? Like, how can you, you know, receive help from the community at large? I mean, it's one thing to, you know, bring a box of food. I understand that. But there's mm-hmm. other needs that you have as well, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We have various programs. We do have a food pantry on site, and so we have many high school groups and student groups that do different food drives for us, confirmation projects. That's another mm-hmm. big one. They have
sure.
to do service work. They'll do food drives for us. But even basic household supplies, you know, hygiene items, mm-hmm. Cleaning supplies, all of those things, which are sometimes really outside of our family and veterans' basic budgets. And so mm-hmm. if we can supplement that, it means that they can pay their rent and be able to put money towards their debts. And all of our program participants pay rent. The program is set up on a very realistic model where rent is a part of your budget. You need to pay your rent. You need to pay your rent on time. And we like to set that from the beginning so that they really get used to that and they're ready to pay rent when they leave us.
Yeah, you know, Monsignor and I were reading about that, the Special Memories Program. Can you talk a little bit about that, Sister?
Yes. Our Special Memories Program was born between myself and a very special woman who used to work at Newground, Carmela Villani. She and her husband are up in St. Aidan's Parish.
Yeah, I know them both. Beautiful people.
Yes, yes. So when Carmela was assisting me, literally, build Newground, we recognized that the family doesn't get any positive mail in their home. So we started the birthday card piece of sending a birth card to every person for every birthday. That's cheap, you know.
Sure.
That was very affordable. Then we were fortunate along the way that another benefactor came forward and said, let's do a Mother's Day brunch. Mm-hmm. And that continues to today, that the mothers are celebrated on Mother's Day. And the veterans are celebrated on Veterans Day. Mm-hmm. So it might be a family that delivers a food, or it might be a donation that we get where we can make sure that each man has a gift for Veterans Day, and that's awesome.
And our Adopt a Family program, I think, is a great way for the community to get involved. We have different, we have seasonal Adopt a Family if someone wanted to do specifically for Thanksgiving or Thanksgiving and Christmas holidays. But then also we have some really generous donors that choose to adopt a family for the entire year. Wow. And so they'll do something for Easter. They'll do Easter baskets. They'll do, you know, something for the summer break. They might do some camp supplies for the children and then back to school supplies, Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's wonderful. That's great. Now, Sister, I'm doing the math in my head. So this is like your 25th anniversary, right?
Yes.
So are you doing anything special for that this year?
We really are. We're having a wonderful year. We have a 25th anniversary committee. We've had an open house on the actual day that we started, Martin Luther King Day.
Oh, wow.
We had a very successful open house. It was so successful, we're having another one on April 17th.
That's great.
It's a Sunday morning. The last one was on the day, which was Friday. We're really hoping people will come again. It takes about 45 minutes to do the walkthrough. Each social worker engages in detail about her aspect of work. So whether it's the special memories, whether it's the social work services, the clinical services, the veterans work, the fundraising that we do, and we have a huge, huge educational program that parallels of equal measure and value to our social work services. Mm-hmm. And the goal is that when they leave us, they have a normal life. What is normal, right?
Yeah, right.
They have had this experience of being cared for in such a way that it's their parents who are providing. Because that has always been a strong piece of the philosophy, that the social workers and the educators are not the handout people.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
It's empowering the parent to be responsible. Because which one of us doesn't want to grow up knowing that our parents took care of us?
I know.
Right,
our parents were the providers. Yeah. And that's one of our goals that we want our children and our youth to see. My mom and dad did this.
Yeah. The dignity of the family.
Makes
the
so
dignity
much, right?
of the family.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what about your website? I mean, if people are interested in that, can they go to your website?
Definitely. We have a lot of different information about these different programs that we provide and also upcoming events. Mairead mentioned our open house that we did January 15th, and we're having one April 17th, and we'll be doing one each quarter this year for our 25th anniversary. So for the information about that and our other events that are going on, they can definitely go to our website.
Well, thank you so much for being here, both of you. Really great information and real inspiration.
Yep.
Thank you for inviting us.
Yeah, it's about hope.
And if anybody calls you and says, what will I do with all the money I have? You say, I know. Where to go?
I have a spot for you.
That sounds good.
Well, thanks so much for being here today
Monsignor.
And being a part of this.
Thank you.
We have lots more good news coming. Stick around. Welcome back, everyone. In a general audience last March, Pope Francis called all of us to reawaken the collective sense of gratitude, appreciation, and hospitality, which makes the elderly feel like a living part of their community. Harvest Houses, directed by the Sisters of St. Dominic, live that directive every day by providing seniors the fullness of living in companionship in a family atmosphere. Located in Syosset and Floral Park in New York, each home accommodates 8 seniors who have access to their own private bedroom, nutritious meals, and a close-knit relationship with friends. From Harvest Houses, please welcome Sister Jean Brendel and Sister Mary Butler. Thanks so much for being
with us.
Thank you for having
me.
Glad to have you at our place. I remember over 10 years ago, I think we went to Syosset, right, with
our
cameras.
Right. Yeah. You did.
That's right.
Great
visit.
Loved having you.
Yeah, it was really wonderful. Mm-hmm.
It was Father's coming.
Here we go. Right? Everybody's excited.
And we're going to be on television.
There you go. So tell us how it all began. How did Harvest Houses begin?
Well, at the time, I was an outreach coordinator. And every day coming to the office was an elderly woman who had lived in the community. Her family grew and moved out of the community. And every day she would come to the office and say, could I just sit here for the day?
Wow.
And which was fine, but I realized she's so lonely that she needed people. That was one thing. And then one day I heard a man in the community was really in need. He was 2 blocks from the parish. I went down, but services for him by the county had begun. The man died. It wasn't financial. It was loneliness. He stopped eating. That experience changed my life. I kept saying, something should be done. What could be done? To get in a senior group there took housing, took 8 years.
Wow.
And I kept saying, there has to be an alternative. Somebody should do something. And finally, one morning, I got up and God said, you do it.
Yeah.
And what? Now, I'm very positive. I said, I'll get a house and we'll live together. And then all the negatives started. Not my, I don't know what they thought we were. Not my area, not here, the zoning laws, everything. Mm. It took us 5 years.
Wow.
But with a wonderful lawyer who did everything pro bono, and with also the help, our first grant was from Human Development from the diocese. And if you remember, Monsignor Real, so supportive, and who always said, residence for the elderly is not a good thing. It is a moral obligation.
Yep. Wow.
And so finally, with all the resistance, we opened in Syosset in 1985.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think we knew from the beginning what we really wanted it to be, and we wanted it to be something creative. We didn't want it to be big where people would get lost. Mm. So I think you touched on it, Monsignor, in the introduction, but our model was to be like a family. It would be living in that atmosphere that most of us have grown up in. And with other people, we haven't grown up in big institutional places. Right. So that was very important, that it would be a place where we could promote relationships, independence, and interdependence. That's always been a big duo for us.
Mm-hmm.
That they would live, and we would live, in an atmosphere of wellness and harmony, and remain involved in the community. You know, years ago when we were studying at Fordham gerontology and social work, the thinking was that as we grow older, we disengage from life. And we know now that's not true.
Sure.
That it is so important to remain connected and be outward and not turn inward. So that's a very big thrust that we have. We believe in life, and we believe that the third stage of life is most significant to the whole of life.
Sure.
And that's our heartthrob.
And I guess to the rest of the world. I mean, that's one of the things the Pope has pointed out 1,000 times, that elderly people have so much to offer us all, and they should never be disregarded, right?
Absolutely,
In so many of the other countries that I visited, people always remark about that in many of these South American, Latin
communities, mm-hmm. the whole family lives together, from the littlest baby yeah. to the great grandparents, and they're all That's in the right. same house, and it's crowded and it's noisy and it's loud, but there's a lot of life there. And it sounds similar to what mm-hmm. you're doing mm-hmm. here.
Well, what I love about the Holy Father, many things, yeah. but what he says family is, we can't do without family. Yes. And that's where it's the give and take. And what Harvest House is, you come and know it's another family by choice. Mm-hmm. And in that, our mission is we will establish an atmosphere where there's peace, where there's harmony, where there's things that will help us all mature. We're not here to fade away. Mm. We need each other. We need the community. Yeah. And what are we handing down to our grandchildren? So it's such we're harvesting our lives. Mm. We're reaping the harvest. And now all those blessings, we got to send wow. them out.
That's so great.
Now, the number eight, too, I'm curious about that. Like, is that what works best, you find? Or like, why did you come up with eight?
I think we always say it's not a magic number. Mm-hmm. But for us, it's not too big.
Okay.
But it's enough to help cover the expenses and to keep the house going. And it's a good number to establish relationships. Mm-hmm. You don't get lost in that yeah. crowd of okay. eight.
Yeah, it's a big yeah. family.
And you can sit, right, and you can sit around the table
and
together.
Because one of the things that's interesting, and again, if you're watching this outside of the country or outside of the state, you can, get this going. Like, this is something, like you said, Japan came to visit
they
you.
They did.
Really?
Right,
right.
To talk
yeah.
about this.
They
right?
have come.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good morning, Japan.
Really?
So, I mean, this is something that can be duplicated and done. I mean, what you've developed is a model that can really be utilized, right?
Definitely.
I mean,
That's our long-term right. view. Right. There ought to be a Harvest House in every community.
Sure. Right.
Because what that does, elders have many losses. Another loss is if they have to move out of their community. Yeah. So that's our great future sure. that we're looking towards. And of course,
and we call it a harvest in abundance.
Yeah,
very nice. Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Very nice.
Now, I know you have these open houses. Talk about that. So can anybody come to these?
Or oh, no? Yes.
Absolutely.
Our ones that we're planning will be in April 24th mm-hmm. and May 1st. In both the houses, usually we do it from 9 to 2. We'd love to see you. Mm-hmm. If those aren't good times for you, give us a call.
Wonderful.
Come anytime.
Excuse me, we have good news to leave you with. And that is that any senior who is independent and is looking for a place, a new living experience, an enriching living experience, Harvest House is the place for you.
That's good. Right.
Good. Yeah. Really. Yeah. Visit our website.
Yeah.
On our website, we have our brochure. We have a four-minute video that really says a lot.
And it's harvesthouses.org is your
Correct.
Website?
Yep.
Beautiful. And the number is up on the screen, too, if you want to give them a call as well, right?
That's right.
Wonderful.
Absolutely.
People
right.
can call, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a great, great idea, and it's so vibrant. And I remember the visit. I remember the people being so joyful and connected to each other. It's just a great thing.
And that's the biggie. That is, they really bond, and they kind of help one another.
Yeah.
We're kind of on the outside, just making sure.
It's beautiful.
But I think later life is time that we can make another chapter in our lives.
Of course.
And it's like, what are you going to do with that chapter?
Yeah.
Come to something. You know, we started 30 years ago, but it's very good news today.
Still is.
Because there's so many new things for elders.
Yeah.
Scary.
Good
well, thank
news,
you so
right.
much for being here. This is exciting.
Thank you for
it's great
us.
To have you both. Enjoy it.
Wonderful to be here.
Yes.
And we'll come visit, all right?
And absolutely.
I'll save a room for you.
Please.
Okay.
Tomato season. I'll be out there when you get the tomato season, all right?
Good enough. Good enough. Thank you.
I'm going to take a quick break, everybody. Stick around. Lots more good news right after this. Welcome back, everyone. Well, I can tell right off the bat you're going to stay involved, right, with these groups.
Could you see my
yes,
brain going?
Yes, I could see it going on.
I
yes,
kept
exactly
thinking,
right.
What can we do? Who can we visit? Where can we go?
Sure. And
such
of course,
great stories.
And at your school, right? You could yes. get things going there, right, without a doubt.
I
right?
would love to. I'd
yeah,
love nothing
thing.
More. I was thinking about that. How can we get the school involved and the kids, too?
And as these guests were walking out the door, I was chasing them down the hallway. Whatever you need, let me know. Whatever you need, right? Because it's all about that.
Yes.
Really
everybody really can do something, no matter what.
That's the truth, right? And I mentioned that even earlier, like, you know, in the book of the letter of James, there's that beautiful reading, which I love so much, that we hear sometimes at Mass, you know, what good is it to have faith and not have works? Faith without works is dead. And that is the truth of our lives, if you think about it. You know, we proclaim faith in Jesus Christ and in the gospel, the Catholic Church, and yet if we don't put our faith into action, we're taking our baptism and kind of putting it under a bushel basket, you know? Our baptism has to shine before the world, and it is about using the gifts that we've been given and sharing them with other people. No matter what our age, no matter what our ability, everybody can do something. Everybody, as I said at the beginning of the show, can pick up a starfish and throw it back to the sea. We can save people's lives. We can change people's lives by our generosity. It's just up to us to kind of figure out, you know, with God's help and the power of the Holy Spirit, what do we need to do? What is the action we need to get involved in? And that's, I think, such an important question we have to ask ourselves every day. You probably do it yourself, but as a mom, you do it probably too, right?
All the time. Yes, I
help
try
the kids
very
to
hard.
Discern that, right?
And you know, Monsignor Jim, when you were talking about, I feel like today it's easier than ever to help. All you have to do is go on a website, click a few things, and in a minute you can help an organization like the people we met today.
And even you with your running and stuff, I get the email right from you. Karen's running again. You want to donate?
And you are my first donator.
I'm usually the first guy on. Yeah,
you get it done, and it's much appreciated.
That's really the reason why, to get it done.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what everybody at home should do.
Yeah,
today.
Just, you know, whatever we can do to make a difference, that's going to be what it's about, right?
That's right.
All right, well, hope you enjoyed the show. Remember, whatever you do this week,
keep on spreading the good.
God bless everybody. See you soon.
Bye, everyone.